Nick Jonas, welcome to the Sunday Project and congratulations on the new album, Spaceman. How does it feel to be finally sharing it with the world, or should I say universe?
I'm thrilled. You know, it's been quite an interesting journey recording the album and actually releasing it. This year has forced all of us to kind of take a different approach to just about everything that we knew, and it's been very different. But I'm very excited that it's out and just thrilled that it's shared with the world and the universe.
Now, the new video shows you seem to have been doing your push-ups. Exactly how much training did you do in preparation for that video?
Well, I haven't been able to do much else. I've been sitting at home. You know, I've always liked working out and staying, you know, physically active, but this forced time at home has lent itself to doubling down on that physical life it's all good. It's better than, I think, sitting on the couch and watching too much Netflix.
Oh, please tell me you've been doing a little bit of that.
Yes, too much of that.
Nick normally calls California home, but he's just touched down in London to be reunited with his wife Priyanka Chopra, the Indian actress he tied the knot with in 2018.
Nick Jonas and Priyanka Chopra are officially husband and wife.
You're on the record as saying that a lot of your new songs are actually love letters to your wife Priyanka. You know that a lot of guys are going to hate you for setting the bar that high, don't you?
Well, if that's what they hate me for, then I'm perfectly fine with that. You know, there's a lot of senseless hatred that's out there, but that's very direct and pointed at something that I'm totally fine with.
Do you ever catch Priyanka listening to some of those love songs that you've written for her?
Yeah, she's, you know, the first person that I like to play the music for and you know, my biggest supporter, and I think that rings true for both of us.
Now, you and Priyanka are in London at the moment, where that interview with Harry and Meghan continues to be the talk of the town. I'm imagining the difficulties that must exist when two famous people come together, everybody wants to talk about them. The British tabloids are known for being particularly cruel. How do you go navigating that together?
Well, I think that, you know, when you live a public life, it can be very, very difficult to navigate all that. And whether it's British press or you know, United States press, wherever that is, or you know, even Australia or India, it's about relying on your family and your friends and your loved ones to help you through those tough times when you have to navigate what I think is truly unfair and at times, as you said, cruel behavior and rhetoric. And you know, in my personal experience, that's all I can ever speak to. I've tried to kind of keep my circle very tight and close knit in order to just keep my head on straight, you know, and stay sort of centered amidst what can be a really chaotic sort of life to live. But, you know, every person's journey is different, and I'm grateful that mine has been one surrounded by a lot of love by people that I know love and care about me, and that means a lot.
Well, Nick, congratulations on the new album, and we hope at some point to see you back down in Australia.
Thank you so much. Great to talk to you.
Well, Nick's new album, Spaceman, is out right now.
Hey there, it's about time you finished that video. I contractually had to wait so I could tell you to subscribe. Subscribe. I'm waiting. Now I can go home. Woo!